In today's video, we will be discussing what are strings in Python and some of their properties. If you are interested, then keep on watching. Hey champions, welcome back to this channel. Let me make one thing clear. Nothing worth having comes easy. So get up and start hustling. In today's video, we will be discussing what are Python strings, how to represent a single character in Python, how to create a string, assigning a string to a variable, multi-line strings, Python strings are immutable, updating and deleting string. You can subscribe to this channel for more such videos. Without any further delay, let us get started with the video. First on our list is, what are strings? Strings are sequences of characters and a character is a symbol. The English language has 26, Chinese has 50,000, while Hindi has 52 symbols. In Python, strings are arrays of bytes representing Unicode characters. To understand the definition better, let's break it down into pieces. The first part of the definition is, strings are arrays of bytes. So when we say an array of byte, we are referring to an array of some defined length, that is a collection of byte-size elements. It is simply an area of memory containing a group of bytes arranged side by side. Now the second part of the definition is, string represents Unicode character. Computer do not understand any language or character, but they only understand bits. Even though you see a character on your screen, internally it is stored as a sequence of zeros and ones. That is, each character is stored as a unique sequence of bits on a computer. The process through which computers map a character to a number is called encoding, while the process of mapping a number back to a character is decoding. ASCII and Unicode are a few of many encodings used. Unicode is a universal character encoding standard that lists every character used by human languages and give each character its own unique code. At a very high level, it's a way of translating characters to integers and ultimately to bits. For example, there's a character for Roman numeral 1 that's separate from the uppercase letter I. They will usually look the same, but these are two different characters that have different meanings. The Unicode helped the computer identify that these symbols are different character in the real world by assigning them unique codes. I hope dividing the definition into understandable parts made it much easier. Now you may ask, do we have any data type which can represent a single character in Python? The answer to that is Python does not have a character data type. A single character is simply a string of length 1. Moving on to the next topic, which is how to create a string. The three most common ways of creating a string are to enclose the string in single quotes, double quotes, triple quotes, which can be both single as well as double quotes. Let us see what happens when we try to print a string without any quotes. As you can see, Python has given us an invalid syntax error, which shows that we need quotes to create strings in Python. It is needless to say that white spaces are also counted as a part of the string in Python. Hope that was easy. Now moving on to the next topic, which is assigning a string to a variable. For assigning a string to a variable, we use an equal sign. The syntax has a variable name followed by an equal sign and the string you want to assign. For example, we have taken a variable var and is assigning a string to it using an equal sign. When we call the variable var in the print function, it displays the string as it stores. Also remember, when you assign two or more strings to the same variable, one after the other, then the last assigned string will override all the string assigned to that variable before it. Example, we have assigned two different strings to the same variable var. First, we have assigned hello world 1 and then we have assigned hello world 2. When we print the variable var, it displays the last string assigned to it. That is, it will print hello world 2 as an output because this string has overwritten the first string that was assigned to it. Next on our list is multiline string. You can assign a multiline string to a variable using three single or three double quotes. To understand this, let us take an example. S1 is a multiline string created using three double quotes, and S2 is a multiline string created using three single quotes. When we execute the print statement for both, Python assumes both the statements are valid and print these strings. Experiment time. Let us try to test if we can write multiline strings using just double or single quotes. First, we will try with double quotes. Here, we have assigned a multiline string enclosed in double quotes to the variable S1. When we try to print S1, Python has given us an error proving that we cannot declare multiline string using double quotes. Now let us try the same using single quotes. This time, we take a multi-line string enclosed in single quotes and assign it to variable s2. When we try to print s2, Python gives us the same syntax error again, proving that we cannot declare multi-line strings using single quotes as well. Also note, while we were doing this experiment, Python was trying to give us a hint that what we are assigning is not a string. The hint was in the form of highlighting done by Python. Anything that is a string is highlighted in red. Any keyword is highlighted in green, while everything else is highlighted in black. As you can see here, Python highlighted champions in red, considering it a string since it is preceded by a single quote. But when we put an enter, Python stopped considering our text as a string and highlighted for in green and life in black. This happened because we enclosed the string in the single quotes. This experiment told us that we can only declare the multiline string using 3 single and 3 double quotes. Now moving on to the most important property of string, which is immutability. By definition, anything that is immutable means that it cannot be changed. If we are calling Python strings immutable, it means that once created, the content of the Python strings cannot be altered. You can only create the new ones, or you can simply reassign different strings to the same variable, but altering the already created string is not possible. Let us try to understand this with an example. We have a string champion, which is assigned to a variable s1. Now we want to replace m in the string with n. For that, we have written s13 equals to n. And when we execute it, Python gives us an error stating that the string object does not support item assignment, which proves that Python strings are immutable. In case you need to change the content of the string, you can do so by either overwriting the whole string or grabbing a part of it and appending it to some other string. Let us see how can we do both. First is overwriting the existing string. Here, we are simply overwriting the already created string by assigning the new string to the same variable. As per our previous example, we wanted to change m with n in our string champion. Hence, for that, we will just assign champion to the same variable s1. When we print the value in s1, it will contain champion. The other option to change the content of the string is by grabbing the substring and appending it to some other string. Let us see how it is done. For replacing m with n in our string, we have grabbed a substring from index 0 to 3 from our original string using the slicing operator and have appended it to n so that now m is replaced with n, and then again have appended this whole string to the substring grabbed from the 4th index from the original string. We will assign this to the same variable s1. This will replace m with n. Don't worry if you don't understand this syntax. We will explain more about the slicing technique in some upcoming video. Similarly, we cannot delete a particular character from an existing string. Let us test our claim. We have a string champion, which is stored in a variable s1. Now, if we try to delete the first letter of the string, which is c, Python will give us an error stating that string object does not support item deletion, which is Python's way of saying that string once created cannot be changed. Even though this method did not delete a character from an existing string, but it can delete the whole string. For example, we have taken the same variable s1, which has a value champion. Before proceeding with the deletion, we have printed the value in it using the print command, which confirms that variable s1 stored champion. Then we have written del s1 command to delete the variable s1. After executing the delete command, we have again used a print command to confirm if the variable still exists. Now, look what Python has returned. It is saying that s1 is not defined. Hence, we can only delete the whole string and not the individual characters from an existing string. This is what a Python string is. We will be making a separate video on indexing and slicing of string in future. So stay tuned for that. You can share your thoughts or questions in the comment box. Subscribe for more such videos. Bye and meet you in the next one.